Returning now to CNN's exclusive polling that shows major racial divides in the UK, including when it comes to Britain's political parties. Black people are significantly more likely to say the country's Conservative Party is institutionally racist, although a sizable minority of white people agree. You see it there, 39%. A Conservative Party spokesperson says, quote, "We're proud to be a party that champions and supports opportunity for all of all races, religions, and backgrounds." So that's the response from the Conservative Party. "Prejudice and discrimination have no place in the Conservative Party, and we will never stand by when it comes to abuse of any kind." Shaun Bailey is the Conservative London mayoral candidate for 2021. His grandparents were part of the Windrush generation who came to Britain from Jamaica in the years following World War II, and Bailey joins me now live from Rumford, England. Thanks for joining us. What do you make of one of the findings of this exclusive CNN polling that suggests that a vast majority of Black Britons believe your party, the Conservative Party, is institutionally racist? What would you say to them?
Good afternoon to you and all your listeners. The first thing I'd say is this, for me, doesn't cover much new ground. It's a conversation that's been had in Britain, for many, many years about which party is more racist or not. And you can trawl through our history, both parties' history, and find that. The point I'd make is, what's the impact going to be going forward? What's the change we're looking for? If I go back to that particular point, when you look at the Windrush scandal, for instance, the Conservative Party was made to own it because we are the government. But the point is, that's a scandal that's been brewing for probably 18 years and more. Some people say 50 years. And in that time, we've had plenty of Labour government, mm-hmm. but they didn't focus on it. And it's a shame for all people in the political class, not just the Conservative Party.
Right. But you're saying it's not new. No, it's not new. And Black people would be the first to tell you this. And I'm sure you've heard it many, many times before. People of color have complained. But it's disproportionately the view among Black people of color that it's the Conservative Party that is more institutionally racist. We have another finding. The Labour Party is institutionally racist. 31% of Blacks agree. 34% of whites agree. So it's really your party that most people perceive as having an issue with race.
I don't argue with your stats, but what I would say, it's because the Conservative Party is more connected to being government, to actually delivering for the country, to being the government. And I think that's where it happens. I think the real question to answer is, what is the whole political class doing? How do Black people view that class of people? That's my major concern, because change in Britain yeah. will come when it moves away from politics. If one person owns it, if one political party owns it or not, you don't get any change. It becomes a political minefield and it's a battle. What we're talking about now is societal change, and that means the changing of hearts and minds, and political parties don't own that space. They cannot deliver in that arena.
Yeah, and you yourself have also been the victim and the target of racist attacks in your political career, right?
For sure. I've had attacks from people from nearly all political backgrounds. I received one just the other day. I was sitting in work in the chamber virtually, and someone sent me an email saying, go back to my mud hut. And that brings me to the real point of the Black Lives Matter campaign as it stands in Britain, as far as I can see. Yes, people keep talking about the law. Yes, people keep talking about Conservative Party, Labour Party politics. But actually, this is a battle for hearts and minds. Institutions are not racist. It's the people within them who enact those systems in that institution. And if we cannot bring the country with us, then we'll make no progress. So the idea that you can just point fingers and call everyone a racist and feel that that's going to get anywhere, I can guarantee you will not make any change. We need to bring people with us. If we learn nothing from Dr. Martin Luther King, that should be the thing. This is a challenge for all peoples, not just Black peoples or white people.
But when you say institutions aren't racist, people are racist. Well, fundamentally, institutions that don't represent, that aren't an accurate and fair reflection of the population of a country are certainly racially unjust and unequal. Do you agree with that? I mean, the representation in education, in the boardrooms, in politics, your field, is very inadequate, isn't it, for people of color?
I think that's a very simplistic look at the problem. What you've effectively said is that someone who is not of my race cannot represent me. I'd push back on that slightly, because this isn't about quotas.
That's actually not at all what I said. I'm not talking about quotas, and I'm not saying that people who are white can't represent black people. I'm just saying that if you do not have a reflection of your country's population in boardrooms, in the political class, in education, in employment, that that is not necessarily just a just reflection of society and a just division of political power. That you don't agree with that.
What I'm saying is, what would be a just division is our children succeeding in school. What would be a just division is us not struggling financially and always being at the bottom of the pile socially. And what that means is we need people, both black and white, in power and out of power, to respect us just as a group of people. My personal take on all this is, mm-hmm. I don't want extra. I want the same as everybody else. I believe in the talent in the black community. I believe if we're given the same opportunities, we will succeed as well. But what I don't want is to be keep pointing fingers at people and accusing them of being racist. Because what they'll do, they'll pull together and they'll fight the message, and they'll make sure that black people don't succeed. This is about bringing people along together.
And when you were chosen as the Conservative mayoral candidate, you came under criticism yourself for something you wrote when you were much younger in 2005 for the Center for Policy Studies. You said essentially if Muslims and Hindus are accommodated in Britain, that you rob the country of its community. And without community, you slip into a crime-riddled cesspool. You have apologized for that. But do you now regret writing those words? I mean, have you come to a different understanding of multiculturalism in Britain just since you've entered politics?
No, what I wrote was talking about how we build community. I grew up in a very big Muslim community. I happen to be a practicing Christian. And how we got along is because we allowed our families to raise our children in the traditions that we were born. And what I said to people was, if what I've written has mm-hmm. caused you some confusion and some pain, more than happy to apologize. Politicians who won't apologize, to my mind, are ignorant. But what I was really focusing on is what it is to be British. We want to have a society where you can follow your own God and your children have no impediment on their future. And that means a shared society, a shared community, a shared idea of what it means to be successful. And that's what I was focusing on. Because on a day-to-day basis, I was faced with poor children and their parents who were saying, why can't we get forward? And I was trying to explain to people, these are some of the challenges we face as non-white people in this country. Let's band together and face them together, but make sure we include our white counterparts in this, because this isn't about them versus us. It's about coming together and moving forward together. Which for us was really important because, of course, mm-hmm. in our own community, we had many poor white people as well.
Right. And a quick last one on your campaign. I mean, you're obviously hoping to be the next mayor of London. Are you imagining yourself already replacing Sadiq Khan next year?
I tend not to do things that. What I tend to do is go around and speak to people. You're talking about a Londoner who's born and bred. I've been homeless. I've been a youth worker for 20 years. I've done so much community work across London. What I want to do is represent the people in London who are fighting to pay their bills every day, the people in London who just want a break to get ahead. And what that means is I don't wake up in the morning imagining I'm mayor. I wake up in the morning with three things on my mind. What can I learn today to support the poor people in my community and the people who are trying to get ahead, and the weak and the vulnerable? That's what I'm about. Imagining being the mayor strikes me slightly a waste of time.
All right. Shaun Bailey, thank you very much, the Tory candidate for mayor of London.